Reading the Wall Street Journal will help you achieve financial independence. And today we're going to go over four distinct and very specific ways that you can read this paper to help you build wealth. Now, before we get started, I just want to tell you, you are never going to find any coupons in the Wall Street Journal. And you know why? Because you can't save your way to wealth. Also, the people that are reading the Wall Street Journal, they are making money. They're not interested in saving money, because saving money is a finite prospect. You can only save so much, but making money is an infinite prospect. Okay, so let's jump right into this technique that has four distinct methods in terms of how you can read the Wall Street Journal to help you build wealth. Now, I want you to understand something. There's a saying, goes a little something like this. The Wall Street Journal is read by the people who run the country. The New York Times by those who think they run the country. The Washington Post by those who think they ought to run the country. And the Boston Globe by people whose parents used to run the country. So who reads the Wall Street Journal? Kings, literally, princes, potentates, love that word, just had to use it, just had to throw it in there. Presidents, this is the newspaper that shows up on the Oval Office desk before the president gets to his office in the morning. It shows up on the desk and in the offices of corporate chieftains, of people who are, you know, interested in policy and politics and how it relates to money. Okay, so if you're running the world, you're reading the Wall Street Journal. If you're rich, you're reading the Wall Street Journal. If you're in the process of getting rich, same thing. So you should be reading this paper. And in terms of how to read the Wall Street Journal, it's our most popular upload. Check it out. Let's jump right into this technique that has four key characteristics as to how you should read this paper in order to build wealth. All right. For starters, turn off your political biases when you're reading the Wall Street Journal or any financial publication for that matter. Remember, what you want to do is build wealth. Okay, so for example, I don't necessarily agree ideologically with all of the money that is being spent in this country today. I don't agree with a lot of what the government, what this current administration has said they're going to spend infrastructure money on, if they should be able to pass this infrastructure bill. However, I am putting my political biases aside in order to examine the reality of the situation in order to make money. So let's take the infrastructure bill specifically. If this measure passes, what industries will profit from it? Well, the green energy industry, the renewable energy industry, for one. So that's a place where I should be looking for opportunities, investment opportunities, to put my money if there's going to be a large injection of government funds into that sector. Hey, I'm a taxpayer, so I'll be paying for it to happen. Why shouldn't I profit from it? Okay, why shouldn't I make money off of it? I am not a congressman. I am not a senator. So my voice will only resonate so far in terms of my opposition to actually spending all of this money. So you have to put your political biases aside when you read the Wall Street Journal or any financial publication. Yours is to make money. And once you can do that, then you can start to see these opportunities as they really exist. Okay, so you got to separate one thing from the other. Number three, respect the data. Now, the Wall Street Journal is filled with all types of charts, graphs, statistical information that allows you to make some very objective decisions in terms of business opportunities and investment opportunities. Again, respect that data. Use it as a starting point to help you do your due diligence and dig deeper into whatever opportunity you are seeking or you have identified as something that may be viable for you to get into to make some money. So don't be afraid of the data. Don't be afraid of the charts, graphs, understand that data can assist you in making sure that you're approaching the situation not just from an intuitive standpoint, but from a standpoint that is informed and objective. That's very important when you're investing or if you're getting into a business. You can't just have 100% emotional enthusiasm about something. You gotta understand whether or not this is a viable opportunity on some level, okay? So, number three, respect the charts and data that are inherent in this newspaper. Okay, number two, seek disagreement. By seeking disagreement, and where you can do that is in the editorial pages. Read some of the editorial pages of the Wall Street Journal. Read some editorials that you disagree with, okay? So that you begin to see a holistic picture of an issue, not just the issue as you want to see it. Otherwise, you're going to develop what's called a confirmation bias. And your confirmation bias will oftentimes blind you to some of the realities that could make your situation more adverse or more profitable, okay? Again, we'll go back to number four where we were talking about how you should, you know, rid yourself of the political biases when you are reviewing the Wall Street Journal, okay? Because if you're blinded, if you're saying, you know, oh, that whole global warming thing, I disagree with that, and, you know, I shall not be moved. That may set you up to miss an opportunity to make some money. Nobody's saying you have to go and buy an electric car or put solar panels on your roof. But if these are industries that are out there becoming more and more profitable, then you got to recognize which way the wind is blowing. So you can't afford, literally, you literally cannot afford to have a confirmation bias. So use that editorial page, that editorial section to seek out disagreement, to understand things from a holistic standpoint. Okay, and number one, using the Wall Street Journal to generate investment and business opportunity ideas. The practical way you achieve this with the Wall Street Journal is by using the business section, the international section, and the future of everything section. Okay, these sections will allow you to germinate ideas around business opportunities, to understand fully where this world is going in terms of investment opportunities. It also, the inverse of that is it'll show you the industries that are starting to wane or to lose economic viability and popularity so that you can be certain to stay away from those industries if you're trying to build an ongoing business. All right, so let me give you a real world example of how you can identify a business opportunity by using the Wall Street Journal. We're going to go into the future of everything section. Recently, they had a write-up in the cities and real estate section, 10 big ideas to improve life in small and mid-sized cities. Now, what that should tell you right off the bat is the customer here is going to be municipalities, all right? So municipalities, they tend to have money. And if you can identify an opportunity here, you may set yourself up to have a city or a county as a client, depending on what type of business you have. Now, some of them, self-driving shuttles, for example, this is a very technologically intensive type of business. And you may or may not be situated as a small business to jump into something like that. But when we start talking about other aspects, universal income, for example, I disagree with it. However, there could be a money-making opportunity there, especially when you start to think about the distribution of the funds or maybe even counseling into how those funds might be better spent to help the recipient achieve financial independence. Okay, here's one that's low-hanging fruit, affordable housing in your backyard. So again, the municipalities are looking for investors who are going to be able to provide affordable housing to kind of fill the gap with a lack of affordable housing in certain areas, especially California. That's definitely a viable idea that small business owners can take advantage of. Online training for job seekers, another opportunity to set up a small business catering directly to a municipality to help them train their workforce, their potential workforce, in new and upcoming advancements in technology so that their city citizens could take advantage of the jobs that are becoming more and more available. Again, tiny housing, another real estate opportunity. Cleaner streets, okay? So you could set up a business catering to cities to make sure that these cities are kept clean. Those are just a few of the most recent ideas in the Wall Street Journal's Future of Everything section. And it's got many more sections than that. The international section will also give you some ideas. So those are four distinct ways that you can read this paper and start to germinate some real, excitement and energy around obtaining financial independence through investment and through business ownership. So don't take it from me. Take it from, again, prime ministers, CEOs, presidents, and princes. They all read this paper, okay? And they all have something in common, which is financial independence, okay? So I hope you guys got a lot out of that. I'll talk to you soon.